After I released my video about path tracing in Unity, Unity added in a denoiser. And so I went back and played around with their path tracing some more. And I believe this change allows you to render in less time while still giving an image that is free of noise. Noise being the unwanted sparkles that can make it hard to tell what you're looking at. This is due to how random path tracing is, because light bounces in many directions, not just one path. So we can remove that noise by processing more samples. After about 500 samples, we get less noise and we can clearly see the image. However, the problem is that the more samples you need to process, the longer your render times will be. And using 500 samples usually took around 5 minutes a frame. So if we can lower it down to 50, we can make it 10 times faster, and by using a denoiser, it cleans it up and makes it acceptable. However, this denoising still benefits from more samples, but it allows you to get by with less. Unity added in two denoisers that you could choose from. There's AppDX and OpenDenoise. AppDX seems to be faster, but it gives subpar results, while OpenDenoise looks much cleaner. With denoising, you can use path tracing and play a game in real time. That is if you consider 3fps while looking like a blurry mess to be real time. And I believe that goes over the benefits of denoising. As for my thoughts, I think this tech is pretty nice as a reference for what lighting should look like. But it's way too demanding on hardware. Even Cyberpunk 2077 only gives me around 20fps or less at 720p upscaled to 4K. I see hybrids of ray tracing with rasterization to be the technique in the here and now. However, the tech is still in its infancy and has a long way to go, and so I'll probably continue forward with ray tracing in Unity. For more information on my journey on choosing Unity after making my own game engine, click on the video that's on your screen.